there's a lot of successful businesses who sail, and there's also sailors that have been successful in business. How do you think competitive sailing influences how you how people do business? Does it make them better?
Well, you know, I was just being asked how come sailing is capable of attract so many different people from different nations to actually one team or one boat. And I think that the nice thing about sailing, which you don't necessarily find in other team sports, is the diversity of talent that you're going to put around a sailboat. You're going to have someone who's highly talented in driving and therefore steering, and he's got a good feeling for, you know, gliding through water and the aerodynamics of water and wind. Might have somebody who's very smart and can see the breeze and the tactical position like on a chess game, so you really need somebody very good with a brain. You might have somebody who's actually very, very strong and physically with a great amount of stamina and speed, and therefore be more adapted to pulling on ropes and hoisting sails and so forth. So I think what's very interesting in a sailing team is that you have a great deal of diversity of talent that you got to put together. It's not all kind of the same people. You know, football, everybody kicks the ball with the foot. Basketball, everybody's got to be able to pass it with their hands. So that diversity does allow, you know, for coordination, for integration of talent, for communication, for all the things that you really need when you need to run a company, because the company is not all about one person making a hammer. You know, it's about, you know, packaging the hammer, it's about promoting the hammer, it's about thinking how we can diversify that hammer versus another hammer. So you in companies, you need the same sort of diversity, and you need to be able to match people, match competences the best you can. And I think that's probably the most relevant thing, which is similar about sailing with business, in addition to the overall tactical and strategical decision making that you have to make on a course. You know, you have strategies about deciding to go right or left, tactics is about deciding how you position yourself if you decide to go right or left versus another boat. And in some ways you do the same thing in business. When you think about a product or you think about a service, you gotta first decide which market you're gonna address. You can't address all markets, so you gotta make a choice. I'm going to take the market on the right or the market on the left. Do I think it's gonna go up? Do I think it's gonna go down? And then once you've done that, then you gotta match yourself against the competition and find a diversification factor that will make you better than the other guy.
Do you think the sport makes enough of the fact that there are successful businessmen, that are successful off the water, people like Nicholas Zinstrom and yourself?
I mean, one of the reasons I'm very pleased that the Extreme Sailing Series decided to open the game for entrepreneur, for youngster, and for female to join by reserving a spot on the boat for them, is that I think there should be a lot more amateurs, entrepreneurs come and join the sport. Same thing with females. I think it is a sport which offered that opportunity. And you have very, very successful series. The most successful series over time in sailing have been mainly sponsored by entrepreneurs. So the owner or the entrepreneur that sponsors a team is an essential part of our sports, and we should never forget that.
Thanks for your time.